amount of fertilizer we use would be less, for example, with the sweet corn, because there's less nutrients, less sugar that's produced. And the other thing that's really different, and it's really hard to tell when you're driving down the road, is the question of, is this GM sweet corn? And lots of folks ask those questions. They want to know. They have concerns. I, as a farmer, have been producing GM crops for nearly 20 years now. We have not seen consistent questions raised. We've seen questions raised, but we haven't seen any kind of consistent evidence that would indicate there's any problem. I don't know if this is genetically modified corn. It's really hard to tell. There's actually no way to tell unless you were to take some of these kernels and look at the DNA. Almost all sweet corn is non-GMO. Now, that's not to say that we're doing that for any reason. Some of that's done for marketing. The sweet corn I raise commercially is not for field stands, it's not for farmers markets, it's for commercial sweet corn that goes into the canning industry, and it's the kind of thing that you'd pick up at your Walmart store, or you might have as an institutional product at a school cafeteria. But the point is, it's canned, it's preserved, and it's fed to people. People eat it when it's still soft, and the sugars aren't as mature as these sugars are here. These have pretty much changed to a full starch. And the sweet corn then would be harvested. A machine would come through, and unless they're hand harvested, these would be snapped off with a unit. They'd be put into a vessel, a truck usually of some sort, and then taken to a canning plant, unless you're harvesting it for your own use. And of course, you can see here, the husks are dry, they're kind of a brown color. That means that this corn is getting mature, and sweet corn, if you see sweet corn like that, it's not good sweet corn anymore. It's past where it's fit for human consumption.